So today we're looking at installing our clip rail system, one of the solid floor systems from the range. As you can see, we've already pre-prepped the floor, insulation down, vapor barrier over the top, and we've run edge expansion around the perimeter. What we're going to be looking to do next is securing the rail into the insulation using a Polypipe standard staple clip. These rails need to be no more than at 1 meter intervals when installing them. You can go a little bit less should you need to, but as long as it's no more than a meter, that's absolutely fine.
So first, today we're going to look at the new Polypipe underfloor heating control pack. Also, we're going to look at the isolation valves and the auto balancing manifold. So first, moving from left to right, we've got the blending valve, which takes a hot supply and a cold supply and ensures that there's a controlled and stable outlet temperature for the underfloor heating system. Moving down from that, we've got a Grundfos UPM-free pump with the Polypipe branding. And at the bottom of that, we've got an elbow. Now, the beauty of this elbow is it enables us to quickly orientate it on the right-hand side of the manifold should we need to. And that's due to these two unions either side being easier to swap out and flip round. Moving on from that, we've got the isolation valves that incorporate temperature gauges, and that ensures we can read a mean flow temperature running into the system and a mean return temperature coming back. So moving on from the isolation valves is the actual manifold itself, which is an auto balancing manifold, which is unique to Polypipe. This incorporates an AFC valve in the manifold, which enables us to, once we've set a flow rate, it maintains that flow rate, whether other circuits have shut down or if other circuits have been set up in terms of the flow rate. The meter long rails can be cut to length using a fine tooth handsaw, and they also simply clip together, which I'm about to show you. Okay, so what we've done, we've evened it out. We've used tape measure to roughly bring it off 50mm off the wall, and we've left enough at the back to get the pipe loops at 180 degrees round and also get our return pipe up the back and into the manifold. Okay, so when we're pushing the pipework into the manifold, we need to ensure it's located all the way into the socket. What you'll do when you push it in, you'll feel two clicks, one pushing through the O-ring and then the second as it pushes through into the grab ring. So as we push it up and into the socket, we've gone one, we've gone two, and then what we're going to do is just tug test down to ensure it doesn't pop out. That just makes sure that the grab rings grip the pipe nicely and it's all the way into the socket. Don't worry if you've forgotten to put the conduit on. So with the fittings being Polymax, it's a demountable grab ring. So all we need to do, once the pipe's into the fitting, you can just put the demounting tool onto there and then the pipe will pull straight out. Okay, so that concludes the installation of the clip rail system. And as you can see, when we was working our way around, we've put a staple on the interval between the rails to secure the pipe, and also at each end of the circuits where the pipe bends 180 degrees. That job was made a lot easier using the Polypipe staple gun. For more information on our underfloor heating systems, please refer to the Polypipe underfloor heating installation guide.